Hi, my name is Tim Ruffalo. I'm nothing more than a friend and fan of the Scorpions. I'm here with the infamous Eddie Trunk, who has an absolute pulse on American music. Now, Eddie, you've had the opportunity to video and interview Matthias, Rudolph, Klaus, even Herman with his new album and his new single. You know what message they're trying to portray to America, but what do you think they have that it takes, and what do you think they're missing to really capture America like they did in the 80s?
Well, I don't think that they're missing anything. I mean, there's nothing that Scorpions are not doing that they should be doing, in my opinion. They are still one of the premier live bands ever. And all you do is have to see them on this tour to see and realize just how incredible they still are. When I saw the guys and I heard they were first retiring, and I had a drink with them in LA, they were doing some press, and I looked at them and I saw them and I said, why are you ending? You guys still look great, you still sound great, and they just made one of their best records that they've ever made. But you know what, I have a lot of respect for the fact that they're ending, because they're doing it for the right reasons. To me, Scorpions were always one of the classiest rock bands ever, and they want to maintain a certain standard, and if they can't maintain that standard, they'd rather not play. That's very admirable to me. As much as I wish they wouldn't go, I think it's very admirable. But I think they're doing everything they should do. They made a great record, they're playing great shows. It's up to the audiences to rediscover this stuff. I think that this music has become a new generation's classic rock, and I think you're going to see a lot more people start to respond to it now.
That's Herman's phone going off, probably an interview request. Let me try to get that turned off. Anyway, if they're trying to get back to the 80s status, though, do you think America, it's just impossible because, like the 60s, you know, the 80s are over?
I don't think that it's over. I just think that it's kind of impossible for... There's really only one band that's come from the 80s that was enormous in the 80s and is still enormous now. And that's Bon Jovi. And the reason why I think they have been successful is because they changed their audiences, they turned over their audiences, they gained a lot of new, younger fans, they evolved and did a lot of changes. And the biggest reason why is because their new music, the new music that they make, gets played on the radio. They've had legitimate hit singles. So when they play live, it's not just about the classic stuff, it's about the classic stuff,
right,
and the new stuff, because the new stuff is really hits. A big part of it, and this is coming from someone who's done radio for 27 years in this country, comes down to radio airplay still. And unfortunately, for as great of a record as Sting and the Tail is, or so many other bands have made, it doesn't get the massive radio hits. It's the same reason why Scorpions existed for 10 years before anyone in America really knew who they
right,
were.
Exactly.
They didn't have a radio hit.
The underground movement, right?
People who knew. They knew about the Uli records. They knew about
right.
Taken by Force. They knew about that stuff. But the mainstream didn't. It didn't become an arena act until No One Like You in America. So the same thing would have to happen for Scorpions or any of these bands. You're going to get the classic audience that's going to come out and see them. You're going to get the people who want to relive those times. And even though they've made a great record, unless it gets played mainstream smash hit single again, it's not going to appeal to new
people.
How
do they go about doing that? Because it is the right material. And you brought up Bon Jovi, and one of the interesting things about him is he doesn't really have a record company. He's his own company.
Well, he has a record company. He manages himself.
But I mean, he's his own entity, basically.
Well,
whereas
to some degree,
the Scorpions kind of put themselves in the machine and hope that the machine does the work for them.
It's very tough. In America, it's only about... It's very difficult because radio generally just plays the older stuff. And it's not just the Scorpions. Scorpions have made one of the best records of their career with Sting in the Tail and the great vocals of Klaus.
Right.
It's not just the Scorpions. Look at the Rolling Stones. The Rolling Stones, one of the biggest bands in history, their new music doesn't get embraced
exactly
in the radio in America. That's the problem. And unfortunately, I'm just one person in one radio show, and I'll keep playing and doing everything I can, but everyone needs to join in to make these songs hits again. When a band like Scorpions are making this good new music, It should be played just like no one like you was.
Exactly.
There's no reason why it shouldn't be. But it's hard because radio in America is a big conglomerate of companies that own the radio stations and very much pull the strings.
Which goes back to my original question. They're like putting themselves in management's care and hoping that the machine produces what they had in the 80s. And they have the material to do what they did in the 80s. They're just not getting the results.
It's nothing to do with the bands. The bands are doing their parts. Scorpions are doing their parts. All these bands are doing their parts. They're still great live. They're still making great music. It's not the bands. The problem is with the way the system is set up in America. Any band that came from the 70s, 80s, even now 90s to some degree,
right,
is looked at as that's what they were and they're locked into that. And any new music from them, well, the hardcore fans will care about it, but it's not given a fair chance.
Now, do you think this is a fair assessment? My contention is, Head Sting in the Tail, Unbreakable, any of these albums of recent years, been released in the late 70s, early 80s, they would have gotten the same results because it was just a different time then. Like, the conditions were there for success. It's not that their music has dropped off. It's that the music industry has absolutely changed. And maybe they haven't changed with the music industry appropriately the way Bon Jovi has. Bon Jovi's, he doesn't trust anybody else. He does his own thing and he stayed on top in America. I don't know what he's doing outside of America. And you have to keep in mind, Scorpions are worldwide. They're huge in Russia, they're huge in Greece.
It's different. It's different. I can only speak for America because that's what I know. That's
me
where
too.
I work. That's where
me
my
too.
Shows are. But I know that it's very frustrating here in America for a lot of bands, and I don't blame them because they make great new music, and outside of shows like mine, there's very few outlets for it. First week, first couple weeks, first single people will play for a little bit, but it's very, very hard. You know, I'll give you a great example of a band that I just have this conversation with all the time. Same thing, like Scorpions, a global band, Iron Maiden.
Right.
Iron Maiden gets legitimate radio play and support for their new music in markets outside of America. When they come here, America just wants to know about the old stuff.
Yeah.
What Iron Maiden does, which gets them in trouble here from time to time, is that they will come here and play nothing but new music.
New, right. They try
and
to cram it down your throat.
They are defiant about
right.
it. This is us. This is what we're doing.
Right.
So they'll do one tour where they do nothing but old stuff. They'll do one tour where they're on that right now where they do nothing but music from the last 10 years. That's a very hard thing for bands to do. Fans are charging a lot of money to come and see them. Fans are paying a lot of money to come and see them. They want to see songs that they know. And it's a balance. It's a tough balance.
All right. Well, from the industry standpoint, you're like an expert witness. So, one, what would you tell the band they would do differently? Not so much create different kind of music, but what they would do differently in America. And B, what would you tell the fans in America what they need to do to get the Scorpions where they were in the 80s, because their stuff has not dropped off. It hasn't dropped. It's the fans and the industry that dropped. It's not the band.
There's nothing. It depends what band you're talking about. If we're just talking about Scorpions.
We're talking about
and
Scorpions.
I'm not saying that because I'm sitting here in the Scorpions room. There's nothing Scorpions need to do.